Good morning, colleagues. My name is Tanya Rodriguez, and can you guys tell me what holiday just passed this last Sunday? Easter. Yes, it was Easter. So today I will be talking about the difference between a rabbit and a hare. Rabbits and hares look similar and both come from the Leopardae family, but they are a different species. Did you guys know that rabbits can be used for meat consumption? Well, it's something I didn't know about, but according to IsraelRabbits.org, about 2 million rabbits were used for meat consumption in the year 2000 to 2001 and can be used for fur, wool, and other laboratory experiments. Nearly all rabbits and hares are healthy animals and don't get sick, but as they grow up to be adults, they can develop dental problems, ear mites, and other issues. Now let's talk about a hare's life and how it differs from a rabbit's. A hare's pregnancy lasts 42 days because of being a bigger size, and rabbit's pregnancy 30 to 31 days because of how tiny they are and can be within more with multiple births. Hares are fully developed when born, according to Philip Stott, who is a wildlife ecologist in a university in Australia. They're born with fur and open eyes, as you guys can see in the picture on the left. And while newborn rabbits are born undeveloped with closed eyes, no fur, and an inability to regulate their own temperature. Hares live above ground and rabbits make their own nests and dig holes in the ground to hide. According to Virtual Nature Trail, for hares, speed is crucial for avoiding predators. For those hares and rabbits that live in the wild, their lifespan can be up to less than 3 years. Stott says hares tend to be larger and are less social than rabbits are. If hares see us, they will get scared and run away. Stott says he tried to feed a hare once and it wasn't relaxed when he was feeding him with a bottle. He says they're prone to have a slight stimulus in their body that if they get too frightened by humans, it can accidentally cause their deaths most of the time, unfortunately. According to Life Science, some hares can be up to the size of a cat and can even be can grow up to be as big as a child, like the picture on the right. Now, rabbits can be interesting and cute creatures. Rabbits can generally live from 8 to 12 years, according to the Guinness Book of World Records, if spayed and nurtured well. They mostly eat pellets, but can be fed greens and veggies, such as lettuce and carrots, even fruits like bananas and apples. They aren't playful creatures, but they love to walk and run around, which is part of their exercise to stay healthy. When their ears start to shake, that means they're scared and annoyed, like the picture on the right bottom. I got my first rabbit when I was just 16. Her name is Cookie, who is 1 year old. She loves lettuce and carrots, likes to run and walk around the house, but mostly she loves to be petted. She's probably escaped her cage like 5 times or more. Luckily, we've gotten her. And yeah, she's pretty chubby, like as you can see her big ball of hair on her neck. Now with drawing into a conclusion, a lot of animals can look the same or have some similarity in physical characteristics, but there is a difference such as rabbits and hares. Our pets can mean so much to us. It's pretty cool to learn about their own family tree and can even turn out to be the same as other animals in the wild, but as a different species. As I mentioned in the beginning of my speech, hares and rabbits come from the Leopardae family because of speed and how fast they can be. Something I never really thought about, but it's nice to know for those of us who have pets. If you ever get a rabbit as a pet, give it what it needs, such as exercise, food, love, and attention. Thank you.